Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Courtney Ryan, and in this video, I'm gonna be doing a Christmas gift guide for 2020. So a lot of you guys have asked me, what the heck do I get my girlfriend, my wife, my significant other for Christmas? So I've compiled a list of some of my favorite things that are on the market this 2020. So just to make it a little bit easier for you guys, I split up this video into 5 different personas for girls. I know not all girls fit in the same box, not all girls like the same things. I would personally like everything on this list, even though it's broken up by types of girls. However, I know that not all girls would, so this is just going to make it a little bit easier. So I have it split up by the girly girl, which is probably most like me, the foodie, the fitness lover, the homebody, and the nature lover, travel lover, adventurous girl in your life. So under each persona, I have about 4 different gifts that I think would be really good gift options for this type of girl. If you have absolutely no idea where to start, no idea what to get your partner, I think that she would really love all these things on this list, or at least I know I would. I'm also going to attach a list down in the description, so it's really easy for you guys to shop. None of these are ads, none of these are affiliated. These are seriously just gifts that I think would be amazing for your significant other this Christmas. So number 1, we have the girly girl / beauty lover / lover of all things girly, AKA me. These are all things that I would absolutely love to receive as gifts. So for her, I have a Revlon blow dryer brush. These are really popular all over TikTok right now. I bought one because everyone was talking about how amazing they are, and it did not disappoint. I'm speaking from personal experience. I love this. This would make an incredible gift. And there's a better option to this if you can spend a little bit more money. All of the things on this list I tried to make really affordable. However, this one kind of has a splurge option, which is the Dyson version. I've linked that down below as well. Not necessary. I think the Revlon brush is amazing. I use it. I love it. But if you could spend the extra money, I know that everyone does love the Dyson as well. Number 2, we have perfume. And I think perfume is just a great gift because you picked it out special for them. Some really cool options down below is Sephora has these little kits where you get all these different sample sizes, and then when you're done and you choose which one you like best, you can turn in this little thing and get the full size bottle at Sephora, which is really cool for someone that maybe doesn't know what they want. I know perfume can get a little bit expensive, so being able to test out a few different samples to see what you like before you get the real deal is always nice. Next, we have the Charlotte Tilbury lip kit. This is what I use. I absolutely love it. This is really popular right now as well. It's one of the best sellers on Sephora, and I can speak from personal experience that this is amazing. Your girlfriend will love this. And number 4, we have the Olaplex hair care set. This is an amazing hair brand, amazing hair products. They're a little bit more expensive, so this could be something that maybe the girl in your life wants but isn't willing to spend on herself or feels bad spending it on herself. When it's a gift from you, it's great. These are awesome products. They work great. I use these as well, so I can speak from personal experience. I love these and would love to get this as a gift. The next persona we have is the fitness lover. So I would also fit in this category. I love fitness, would be so happy to get any of these. So number 1, we have a Fitbit. Really just any kind of fitness tracker I think is a really good gift for someone that doesn't already have one. Again, here I have a save option and a splurge option. So a Fitbit is good for saving, a little bit more budget friendly. If you're willing to splurge a little bit more, an Apple Watch is a great choice. While I don't have one personally, my mom has one, she loves it. I know a lot of other people that have them and love them as well. And it's great for someone who is really into fitness, really active, loves to work out, and wants to track their steps, track their activity on their watch. Number 2, we have a new pair of athletic shoes. These are things that you don't really have to buy that often, so when you get them, it's like a big deal. The ones I've linked down below are the Adidas Ultra Boost. I love these. Not only are these functional, but they're stylish too, which all girls like. We all like to look cute at the gym, and these do the trick, so love the Adidas Ultra Boost. Number 3, we have a pair of Lululemon leggings. If you don't want to do the leggings, you could always get something else from the store, but I think that anything from Lululemon is just a really great gift. It's an awesome athletic brand, but it is pricey. When I get it as a gift, it's always really nice to receive. And number 4, I think a really cute gift idea could be a little at-home workout kit. I know a lot of things are shutting down again. People are stuck at home. It's winter. Maybe we don't feel like leaving our house. And getting a little at-home workout kit that she can use is a great idea. So I was thinking maybe a yoga mat, a pair of resistance bands, and then a pair of ankle weights could be a really great gift. If you package it all together, it could be super cute. The next persona is the homebody. I love being home. I love self-care, pampering, all of that kind of thing. And since we're all home a lot more these days, I think this gift makes sense. It works for anyone. So number one, we have a silk pillowcase and eye mask. These are from the brand Slip specifically. This is a little bit more of a splurge as well. Everyone raves about this brand. They're super cute and the set just looks adorable together and makes a really cute gift. Number two, we have candles. So I linked one below that is my absolute favorite. Teddy just bought it for me actually. It's called Boy Smells. They have a ton of different options, but they are a little bit pricey. It's like $40 for a candle. I could not believe when Teddy showed up with this. I was like, why the heck did you spend $40 on a candle? But actually I love it and I'm glad that he did. But again, another thing I wouldn't buy for myself and is awesome to receive as a gift. If you don't want to spend that much on a candle though, a candle from literally anywhere is a great idea and I've linked some of my favorites below. Next we have a diffuser and essential oils to go along with it. So I love my diffuser. I use it every night. It's really relaxing and just puts me in a really great mood. So this could be a good gift for her, but could also be a good gift for you if it's going to increase her mood. A lot of essential oils are multi-purpose as well, so you get a little bit more use out of them, which I really like. And number four is face masks, pampering, all of that kind of stuff. So any kind of skincare, if you know that your girlfriend or significant other is really into that, this could be a really great gift as well because skincare can get a little bit pricey and it's nice to not have to buy it for once for yourself. So I've linked a couple of my favorite kits that Sephora is offering right now. They have a ton of really great sets right now on their website for the holidays. I've used all of these brands before and I really like them. So I can confidently give the recommendation to all of you that these are great. Next up, we have that nature lover, the travel girl, the adventurous girl. Number one is a plant. I have so many plants. I love them. They make great gifts. They're pretty affordable too. You don't have to go crazy. Even if you just get her like a little succulent or something small, she will love it, I promise. Number two is a book. If you know that your significant other likes to read, this could be a really good option. I have a best friend that reads about 200 books a year. I'm not exaggerating, maybe a little bit, but she reads so much and she recommended these books to me. They're new in 2020, so your girlfriend probably doesn't have them already and they would make really great gifts. Next, we have a passport holder and luggage tag. Like I said, for that girl in your life that loves to travel and we can travel again after COVID, this could be a super cute gift. Lastly, on this one, we have a beanie. So if she's adventurous, she likes nature, maybe she likes to be outside, this is perfect for those colder months and I found some adorable beanies below. These can make really cute gift sets too. So if you're going the more like gift set route, you could get a beanie and then put like a luggage tag and the passport holder and just make like a cute little basket, which would be a really great gift. And all the stuff is pretty inexpensive. So then when you put it all together, it just makes a really nice gift basket. I also have a little bonus for this one. I found this really cute calendar on Anthropology. It's like a bon voyage calendar and every month is a different place. This is just really cute if you know you're with someone that likes to see the world, wants to travel, all of that kind of stuff, she'll love this one. Lastly, we have the foodie. So number one, we have the always pan. I don't personally have one of these, but after seeing it all over Instagram, a ton of influencers that I follow have these and I think they are so cute. It's like a stylish pan. It's a little bit more pricey too, but I think you really do get what you pay for this one. Number two, we have a cookbook. These are just always really cute gifts. I love getting these kind of things. Any kind of book in general, I think is a good gift, but especially cookbooks because even if you don't use it all the time, it's one of those things that you can just pull out when you need it. Even if she doesn't use it right away, she might find herself using it later. But if you know someone likes to cook and they're really into that, this makes a really awesome gift. Number three is a mini waffle maker. I want one of these so bad. I think they are super cute. I always see them at Target and walk a little slowly when I'm walking by where they are in the store. They're super inexpensive too. I think it's only like $10, which is not a lot at all. So if you just started dating someone and you know they like to cook or bake, this could be a really cute, fun idea. And number four on this list is a Chemex, or really any kind of like coffee accessories I think are really popular right now, but there's a ton of them out there. You could get a frother, a Chemex, some kind of French press or something like that, or make a little coffee kit. That could be a really great idea. I don't know about you guys, but we go through coffee so fast in this house. I love having all of these different tools to make my mornings a little bit brighter. So I think any kind of coffee related gift is always a good idea. Unless, of course, she doesn't drink coffee, then probably don't get this one. I also wanted to give some gift card ideas as well for all of you. Maybe that just started dating someone and you don't want to get something too personal yet, but you still want to get her something, or even if the person you're with is really picky and likes to pick out her own stuff, these could all be really great as well. So number one, we have a gift card to get a manicure and pedicure. This is something that I get religiously, but it's nice when you don't have to pay for it and someone else buys it for you. If you know this is something that she often gets for herself, it's just nice to get this as a gift. We also have Sephora, Williams Sonoma, Container Store, Target, Amazon, and lastly, Starbucks. That's always a good one. If you live by a local coffee shop, I think it's always great to support small businesses as well. So maybe opt for that instead of the Starbucks card if you know that she often visits a cute local coffee shop in your area. So guys, that concludes my gift guide for the woman in your life for 2020. I hope you all found this helpful. And I do want to mention that I purposely didn't do a luxury gift guide or a very expensive gift guide. Sometimes I think the more inexpensive gifts honestly mean a lot more. I think it's nice to get something that you know someone put thought into and they thought about you when they purchased it and didn't just get the most expensive thing out there. So I would personally love to get anything on this list. I'm really not picky when it comes to gifts. I think that anytime someone thinks of you and puts effort into buying something for you or just buy something for you in general is so sweet and such a nice gesture. I hope that the girl in your life feels that way too. None of us want to be with a spoiled brat that feels like she should only be getting a Louis Vuitton bag or a Mercedes in the driveway with a big red bow for Christmas. While all of those are really great gifts as well, obviously we all want nice things. I think that sometimes the inexpensive gifts go a long way and mean a lot more than you guys probably think. So guys, if you found this helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for when I release new content. Also, be sure to follow me on Instagram at Courtney Christine Ryan. I love connecting with all of you guys on there as well. And I will probably be posting some more gift ideas on my stories throughout the month as Christmas approaches. I know some of you guys wait till the last minute. That's all right, been there, done that. I know a lot of guys do it. So if you need some last minute gift ideas that weren't on this list, I'll probably post them on my Instagram too. So be sure to follow me to stay in the loop for all of that. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all next time.